Well, welcome to another edition of Mount Zion's Faith Over Fear Sunday School Lesson. Now, before we get started, let's give a big shout out to our new President of the United States, President Joe Biden, and our first African-American and woman Vice President, Mrs. Kamala Harris. Oh, this is a historical moment. Let's keep both of them in our prayers. Well, in our lesson last week, I asked you, how fast can you run, remember? Well, for this lesson, I have a different question for you. And my question is, how strong are you? Do you think you could lift a 500-pound weight? Or do you think that you could defeat 1,000 men using a bone of an animal as your only weapon? Nah, you might be strong, but I know you're not quite that strong. And I'm pretty sure that you are not as strong as the strongest man that ever lived. After our prayer and opening song, you will see a video about the strongest man that ever lived.
Hi, I'm Dean Edwards, and I'm in 10th grade, and I go to Charlottesville High School. I also go to Mount Zion First African Baptist Church. Let's all bow our heads. Father God, my Lord and Savior, I pray that you will watch over all the kids and children and adults who are worried about the future. I pray that you will guide all the doctors and nurses for the healing those who are sick in the hospital. And I pray that you will guide our new president that will be inaugurated soon. And I pray that you will continue watching over us and loving us as you do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Make a big noise, we're all gonna live forever in heaven someday. Get a smile on your face, you're saved by grace. It's time we all lift our voice in praise, saying we love Jesus. We love Jesus. Jesus died for everyone, anyone, whosoever will can receive his love today. Have your sins erased, receive his grace. Wave your hands all over the place, saying we love Jesus. We love Jesus. Whether you're an old man, poor man, give him your life, you will live in heaven someday. Get a smile on your face, saved by grace. Somebody better help me give the Lord some praise. We love Jesus. Sing it, come on! We love Jesus. We love Jesus. We love Jesus.
There was a time during the history of the Israelites where their disobedience grew so rapidly that the Lord handed them over to the oppression of the Philistines. For 40 years, they suffered and longed for someone to set them free. During this terrible time, there was a man named Manoah from the tribe of Dan. His wife was unable to become pregnant. They desperately longed for a child of their own, but it never happened. One day, an angel of the Lord appeared to Manoah's wife and told her that she would have a son. She was excited, but found it hard to believe. The angel of the Lord appeared a second time and told her that she was not allowed to drink any wine or eat any forbidden food. He also told her that the boy's hair should never be cut This was to be a sign to others that he was consecrated to God. When the boy was born, she named him Samson. Samson grew up to be a strong young man. He had long hair, and his mother made sure that he obeyed all the instructions the angel gave. Samson was blessed by God, and God's Spirit began to work in him. One day, while Samson was in Timnah, he saw a beautiful young Philistine woman. He liked her very much and wanted to take her as his wife. There was just one problem. The Philistines were Israel's enemy. Samson told his parents about his plan, but they were not happy. How could their son even think of marrying a Philistine girl? They were Israel's enemy and treated them poorly. Little did Samson's parents know that God was planning this all along. Samson, after all, was to be Israel's judge, born to free them from the oppression of the Philistines. The plan went forward, and Samson was set to marry the Philistine girl. The girl's father gave Samson 30 young men to be his companions. During the festivities of the wedding, Samson told the men a riddle and said he would give them 30 fine linen robes and festivity garments if they could solve it. Then the men forced Samson's wife to entice him to tell her the answer. She succeeded, and the men won the bid. Samson was furious for being tricked. He had to keep his end of the bargain and was forced to give the men their 30 linen robes and festival garments. In order to do that, Samson killed 30 men and stole their linen robes. What's worse, when he came to take his bride, he found out that someone else had married her in the meantime. Samson was going to get even with the men who tricked him. He captured 300 foxes and tied torches to their tails. The foxes ran like crazy, setting everything on fire. All the crops and trees burned down. Now the Philistines were angry too. They, in return, went and killed Samson's previous wife and her father. When Samson heard the news, he was furious. The situation escalated. At that time, both the Philistines and Israelites saw Samson as a problem. The Israelites tied Samson with rope and brought him to the Philistines. With ease, Samson snapped the rope, picked up a jawbone of a donkey, and killed 1,000 Philistine men. Years later, Samson went to the city of Gaza. When the inhabitants learned that he was there, they devised a plan to capture him. They would wait for him until morning and then kill him. Samson, though, did not stay the entire night, and before the morning broke, he walked to the city gates, ripped the doors open, and carried them on his shoulder to the top of the hill. In his disobedience, he fell in love with another woman and told her the secret of his great strength: his long hair. The woman didn't care about Samson and told the Philistines how to capture him. That night, while he was sleeping, she chopped off his hair. When the Philistines captured Samson, there was nothing he could do. The Spirit of God left him, and his amazing strength was gone. They poked his eyes out and put Samson in jail. Finally, they caught the man who wreaked havoc in their land. There in jail, Samson was forced to grind wheat, the job of an ox. What the Philistines did not realize was that Samson's hair was starting to grow back. One day, the Philistines took Samson out of prison. Samson came to stand between the pillars supporting the roof of the building where the festivities were held. Blind and weak, Samson asked one of the servants to place his hands on the pillars. He prayed one last time for God's strength, and with amazing force took down the pillars that held up the building. It caved in, and Samson, along with 3,000 men and women, perished.
Well, there you go. Samson, the strongest man that ever lived, but certainly not the smartest man that ever lived. As you saw in the story, Samson's parents longed to have a child, and God blessed them with a very special son. a son who was to become one of the judges of Israel. A judge in those days was more like a king than the judges we have today. Well, God told Samson's parents that he should never, never cut his hair, for his hair was a sign to everyone that he was very special to God. God told Samson that if he ever cut his hair, he would lose the amazing strength that he had. Well, later in the story, a Philistine woman that Samson was to marry tricked him by giving his servants the answer to a riddle and caused him to lose an important bet. And the second Philistine woman that Samson fell in love with was named Delilah. Oh, she tricked him into learning the secret of his strength, which was his hair, remember? When Samson was asleep, she cut his hair, causing him to lose his hair and lose his power. Now, we should know that Samson's power was not really in his hair. His power was in his obedience to God. And when he was no longer obedient, he lost his physical strength. And then all the Philistines captured him and put him in jail in chains. Later, Samson prayed and asked God to restore his strength one more time so that he could get revenge on those evil Philistines who tricked him. And that is exactly what God did. He restored his strength. It was a great story with a very powerful lesson about obeying God. As with Samson, so many years ago, God still expects us to obey him as well. For Samson, he was told by God to not to cut his hair. And God has many commandments that he expects us to obey as well. For example, you can just look at the Ten Commandments found in the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verses 2 through 17. God gives us commandments not as an excuse to punish us when we fail, no, but as a rule book of how to live a life where we can be blessed by God. What's your reward for obeying God's commandments, you might ask? Super strength, maybe? Probably not. But doing our best to follow his commandments and asking for forgiveness when we do not follow his commandments will give you a life where you can call upon a super God to help you no matter what you're going through. So remember to obey your parents and obey God so that you can live the wonderful life that God has planned out for you. Well, I want you to know that that completes our lesson for today. So next we will have our Black History highlight followed by a closing song. And as always, remember you keep your faith and remember that your faith is greater than your fears.
Hi, I'm Jean Edwards, and today I'll be reading a little bit of Black history. Specifically, we're talking about Rosa Parks. Rosa Parks stood up for African Americans by sitting down. Although Abraham Lincoln's 1863 Emancipation Proclamation granted slaves their freedom, for many years, Black people were discriminated against in much of the United States. In Southern states, for instance, most Black children were forced to attend separated schools from white kids in classrooms that were often run down with outdated books. African Americans couldn't eat at the same restaurants as white people and had to sit down in the back seats of public buses. Segregation, the separation of races that was enforced by local laws. Rosa Parks was born on February 4th, 1913, on December 1st, 1955. She boarded a city bus in Montgomery, Alabama, and sat in the middle, where Blacks in the city were allowed to sit unless a white person wanted the seat. As the bus filled with new riders, the driver told Parks to give up her seat to a white passenger. She refused. The driver called the police, and Parks was arrested. Her arrest sparked a major protest. For more than a year, most Black people in Montgomery stood together and refused to take city buses. One of the leaders of the boycott was a young local pastor named Martin Luther King Jr. Public vehicle stood idle and lost city money. Still, the Montgomery bus boycott didn't end until 1956. Supreme Court decision ended the racial segregation on public transportations throughout the United States. Parks passed away on October 24th, 2005, but throughout her life, her refusal to give up her seat inspired many others to fight for African-American rights and helped advance the civil rights movement of the 1950s and 60s. I hope you enjoyed learning about Rosa Parks with me. I hope you tune in for another video later.
Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes.
Now, hold your shield for your faith now. Get steady, cause it's here now.